This is the weirdest looking FDM 3D printer I think I've ever seen. It looks like something's missing, but I can't quite put my finger on it. You know, because it's missing? Well, keep watching because today we're going to take a look at this bizarre bed slinger and see how it prints. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Today, we're going to get a look at this new Comgrow T300. Thanks to Comgrow for sending this over free of charge so I could show it to you. I was going to do an unbox and build video because there wasn't one yet, but between the time I documented and scripted and recorded all the steps and today, Comgrow / Sobol released their own unbox and build video, so I'm dropping that part. What I'll do instead is cover the specs and show you a model printed from the pre-sliced files that come with the printer. I'll also show you that same model sliced and printed with Comgrow / Sobol slicer that they include with the printer. And then I'll show you something I printed using a completely different slicer, and you'll see why I switched when we get to that part. Ready? Here we go. Here are the T300's specs. It's a fast, clipper-based bed slinger with a build volume of 300 millimeters on X and Y and 350 millimeters on the Z axis. And the X, Y, and Z axes move on linear rails. The tool head has a direct drive extruder with a 6.5 to 1 gear ratio to push 1.75 millimeter filament through a 0.4 millimeter nozzle that can get to 300 degrees Celsius. The tool head also has LED lighting to make it easier to see what the nozzle is doing, an inductive bed probe for mesh bed leveling, and of course, a filament runout sensor so it can let you know when you need to run out and get more. Okay, for that one person who's tired of hearing it, I asked in the last video if I should keep running with that joke, and not one person said no. So there. The bed can get up to 100 degrees Celsius, and it features a double-sided textured PEI flex plate to make removing prints easy. There are also alignment guides at the back corner of the bed to make it easy to put the flex plate on again. It's also got a 4.3-inch color touchscreen with a decent viewing angle. The main board has a 64-bit processor running Clipper. It's got Wi-Fi and Ethernet and a pair of USB ports. The printer comes with the usual assortment of tools. Hex wrenches, screwdrivers, a scraper, nozzle unclogging and unjamming tools, and a spare nozzle. Since the nozzle is proprietary, having a spare on hand is a good thing. It even has flush cutters. Yep, the printer not only has Clipper, it also has clippers. The T300 has a couple of unique features too. One is the Z axis, which doesn't have a crossbar spanning the gap at the top of the towers. The other is the clever way the motion components are hidden on all three axes behind these shiny metal strips. It gives the printer a sleek, modern look. Now, let's take a look at a couple of prints. This first one was on the USB flash drive that came with the printer. Surprise, it's a Benchy! For this, I used Polymaker's Red Polysonic PLA. It's intended for high-speed printing. This printed startlingly fast, and about 15 minutes after telling the printer to start, I had this fine, Benchy-shaped object. It's not 100% perfect by any means, but for 15 minutes worth of printing, it's a pretty respectable showing. Looking at the first layer, I decided that I needed to adjust the Z offset to bring the nozzle a little closer to the bed. And there's a small defect on the bow. And there are some gaps in several areas on the top surfaces of the model. But I've said before, these tuned for speed, not for quality Benchies are just that. They're designed to be printed as quickly as possible, and quality is not generally part of the calculus for that. So, knowing that the Benchy I just printed was tuned and optimized for speed, I wanted to see how well the T300 would print a Benchy if I sliced it using the Comgrow branded Cura slicer that was included on the flash drive that came with the printer without any special settings. So anyway, I sliced a standard Benchy using the fine 0.2 millimeter settings in Comgrow's version of Cura and printed it. This is more of a 30 minute Benchy. While the surface finish of the Benchy I sliced is nice and glossy, I wasn't super happy with the amount of stringing. There's just way more than I was expecting. I think I'd give both of these Benchies a rating of 3 out of 5 stars. Both of them are good in certain ways and bad in certain ways. So I wasn't happy with all that stringing. I saw that Orca Slicer has settings for the Comgrow T500, so I used that and adjusted the build volume to match the T300. and that worked out great. So using the T500 settings with the reduced build volume, I sliced and printed all the parts for this. It's Ricky Tanner's VSV, or Variable Support Vehicle. Ricky is a fan of the 1980s Hasbro G.I. Joe toys, and he designs printable vehicles in that style, scaled for those 4-inch action figures. The army green color is Protopasta Derek's Olive Drab HTPLA. The interior is printed solid beige 500 PLA, and the tires are Overture Black TPU. I'm very pleased with how this one turned out. The colors are great, the tires are nice and squishy, the doors open all fancy-like, and it rolls great too. And there's definitely a link in the description for this. So that's the Comgrow T300. The hardware is gorgeous. The included slicer settings, those are awful. But you can work around that by using Orca Slicer's T500 print settings. Add the T500, adjust the build volume, and save it as a T300, and off you go. Hopefully, Comgrow will get their T300 settings straightened out, and maybe get them rolled into the next beta or full release of the standard Orca Slicer. Then you just need to download Orca, and it would already have the settings without you having to mess with it. The T300 is a beautiful machine. It did great with the VSV project. It even handled flexible TPU like a champ, and it's about $460 on the Soval website. Links in the description if you want to check it out. Thanks again to Comgrow for generously providing the printer. And big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something really cool. The doors open all fancy-like, and it rolls great right into the printer.